We have seen in my previous video, how RNN works. And what are its difficulty? That is, if we have sentence like, color of apple is. RNN can return the answer as red. But what happen if the predicted word is dependent on the word that are far away? That is, if we have sentence like, I grew up in Nepal. I speak fluent. RNN may fail to return true answer. To solve this problem, LSTM and GRU comes into the picture. If we pass same sentence to our LSTM or GRU model, it may return answer as Nepalese. Because obviously if a person is from Nepal, then he or she speak fluent Nepalese. And if a person is from Japan, he or she speak fluent Japanese. So, LSTM, long short-term memory, and GRU, gated recurrent unit, are capable of learning long-term dependencies. They are best used in speech recognition, speech synthesis, and text generation. You can see the architecture of LSTM and GRU. Don't get worried by looking this architecture. This is not that much hard. I will explain this in a very easy way. First, we have LSTM. We have several parts in LSTM. They are, forget gate, input gate, cell state and output gate. You can see the forget gate clearly in this architecture. In this forget gate, each information pass through sigmoid function. Do you know about sigmoid function? It returns value from 0 to 1. If it returns value near to 0, this means the information is not that much important. Whereas if it returns value near to 1, this means the information is important. So we can forget the information if the value comes near to 0. And we have to keep the information if the value comes near to 1. Next, we have input gate. When each information is passed through this input gate, the information is passed through sigmoid and tanh function. Sigmoid function means to identify whether the information is important or not. Whereas tanh function is used to map value between minus 1 and 1. The results from these two functions get multiply and pass further. Next, we have cell state. Information are stored in cell state. If the information is important, we keep the information in the cell state. The important information comes from the forget gate, right? And also the result from the input gate is added to this previous cell state. The cell state is kind of like a conveyor belt. It runs straight down the entire chain, with only some minor linear interactions. Next, we have output gate which decides what the next hidden state should be. You know the function of each operation that are included in this output gate. That means we are keeping the important information for long run and forgetting the useless information. We are adding that important information and finally we have to pass this to the next layer. This is how LSTM model works. GRU model is similar like LSTM. But GRU model has only two gates. That is, reset gate and update gate. Update gate acts similar to the forget and input gate, that we have seen in LSTM. That is, it decides what information to keep and what information to throw away. Whereas reset gate is used to decide how much past information to forget. This is the new gate in GRU. Other all are same. We have to decide on the basis of our project whether to choose LSTM or GRU. Both of these models are capable of solving many competitive tasks. This is all about LSTM and GRU. These two architectures are different from the simple RNN. In RNN, we don't have a lot of operation. So LSTM and GRU are more powerful than simple RNN. We will make one project using LSTM in my next video. we will predict the next word using LSTM. So, stay tuned, and if you like this video, please hit the like button. Subscribe this channel. I will meet you soon. Stay safe and keep learning.